Did you have a good summer?
I did. I have had a great summer. You know, went to France again.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I've been going all the time now because that's where my wife likes to take her vagina on vacation. So.
Wait, what? What does that mean? What does that mean?
For some reason, she likes to go to France. I mean, she's French, and she likes to, you know, that's where she takes her vagina, so that's where I go.
Wow, I haven't seen you in a while. Things have changed. So what do you do in France? I'm scared to ask.
Just hang out, just vacation with the family and all. It's nice. We have a good time.
Yep.
You know, it's they still speak French. They still a lot of French over there.
All the French people.
All the French people.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's funny. This time, my daughter picked it up. Mm-hmm. It was so cool. You know, so they speak French, but when we're in France, they were in a
how old
in
are your twins
boundary.
Now? Four.
Four. Yeah. Okay. And she turns to her mother, her grandmother. In French, she tells her, hey, they speak French here, too. And I'm like, you're in France, dummy. Of course, everybody speaks French. But she
You said that to your daughter?
So cute. I didn't say that to my daughter.
And does your son, does he speak French as well?
Yes. Yes, they both speak French.
Wow. So then you have to start learning French. You must know some more French now.
Well, I know more, but it's kind of nice not knowing. It's kind of nice, you know, like they ask me for stuff and I go, I have no idea what you just said.
Yeah, right.
I have no idea. So yeah. I can ignore more things.
But wouldn't you get paranoid that they're all talking about you in French and you don't know what they're saying?
Sometimes, but I just listen for noir. Anytime I hear them say noir, I know they're talking about me. Uh-huh. Anytime, you know, something black, they say black, I go.
And which one of them got in trouble?
Lucas. Yeah, because you know they go to a French school. They go to French school. So there must be something wrong with me because I'm basically paying for them to learn not to be able to communicate with me.
Right. Yes.
So there's a problem there.
Yeah.
But so Lucas got in trouble. But I think he adores me, and I think he's trying to, you know, like trying to like emulate me a little bit, but just going about it the wrong way. Okay, so I got an email from the teacher, and the teacher said, "Dear Miss Sykes, sorry to contact you like this, but today at recess, Lucas pulled down his pants, grabbed himself, and was laughing and chasing the other kids around the playground. So he's just out there." Yeah. But as soon as I told him, you know, to stop, he quickly pulled up his pants and, you know, and stopped. And then she said that I explained to him that was very inappropriate and it wasn't funny. And she said, and he responded to me in English, "It is funny." It is funny. And then she said, okay, so she got the French teacher to explain to him in French what he did was wrong and it wasn't funny.
Right.
And she said, Lucas turned to her and said, it is funny. Uh-huh. It is funny. So, you know, so she continued to learn and asked me to talk to him. So I sent her an email back. I said, Miss Karen, I said, I'm so sorry this happened today. I promise you I will speak with Lucas and this behavior will not happen again because it is very inappropriate. But as a professional comedian, I must say, it is funny.